8.
And then here's
7,
Adrift.
6, 5, 4, 3.
I like that white blade
1.
On Adrift.
Fight, robots, fight.
Ooh. Flightless is getting spun up. Oh, and it got pushed into the corner. Oh.
Oh, and a belt.
Yes, I see.
Oh, that's
no.
not happy. That's not happy. When your weapon is also your drive, losing a weapon belt is a big deal.
One of the challenges with Flightless is that it can only drive forward, and it needs to...
That's a vicious hit from Adrift. Yeah, Flightless, only one weapon, which means they are able to move, but it is a very slow crab walk. Oh, that's not where you want to be, Flightless. You don't want to be running into Bert. He doesn't like it. He gets angry.
You say, oh my goodness, he's
now. It looks like Adrift's drive is not all the way up.
The left side is not happy on Adrift's drive, that is for sure. And you can see that weapon on Flightless is really vicious.
Both of these bots, very aptly named.
That's true, Chris. Yes, that's true. Now, if you were curious about how Flightless works, because now we're seeing it in action, the bristles on this robot are not electrified. They don't vibrate. They are just static bristles from off of a grill cleaning brush. And Cody, the builder and driver of Flightless, really needs to have those horizontal weapons up so that that robot can get the lift and the vibration necessary to move around the box. And we are seeing some pretty impaired driving from both of these
But
bots.
Flightless able to get themselves off of the wall there. Look at how badly broken that the shaft is on the weapon. You can see they're still trying to spin it, but there's no tension on that belt because that shaft is just completely broken off at the top.
You got 40 seconds left in this match.
And Adrift, they're just kind of spinning in circles. I'm a little surprised that there's been no show motion on them, honestly. But
Twenty-five seconds left here in this match.
I think that might have been the last exchange that we'll likely see.
Yeah, I think so as well. We're down to the last now 15 seconds.
I think we'd need at least another 4 minutes for them to reach each other.
The mini-bot now doing all the work in this fight, as we've seen so many times. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's the end of this fight. This one will go to the judges.
Loser's bracket round 2, we saw Adrift with some more drive reliability issues.
Yeah.
And Flightless. Kind of a similar second outing for Flightless.
Yeah.
All right, let's start with you, Jack. Your thoughts on this fight, Flightless versus Adrift.
So I would have to give my vote to Adrift purely because Flightless had no motion at the end, but it's begrudgingly that I give it that because I feel like Adrift should have been counted out a good bit sooner than the fight ended, but that's the call of the box manager, and so Adrift gets my vote.
All right, we've got one vote for Adrift. Andrew, your thoughts?
Yeah, not a lot to say about this fight. I'll just go for Adrift on this one.
All right, we've got two votes for Adrift. Don, take us home.
Make it 3.
All right, we've got a unanimous judges' decision for Adrift, which limps along in the loser's bracket. Flightless will be going home early, but I really hope that we can see Flightless again.
Yeah.
I love an unconventional robot. I love a 5-pound, 3-pounder. I love the thinking that went into the engineering and the design of that build. And I'm really hoping that Cody brings Flightless back.
Same.
All right, loading into to box one, we've got ZZBot versus Black Adder. These are going to be two horizontals.
Yeah,
and,
very similar bots.
Two vector-ish kits.
Heavily modified at this point, vector kits, yeah.
Yes.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fight, robots fight.
Blackadder thought about doing a box rush, then changed its mind. Oh, that's the black armor on ZZBot gone. Okay.
One of the cool things about seeing two heavily modified vector kits against one another is that you can see, you know, they have similar geometries.
Very, right. Yeah.
And they have to make decisions with the rest of their weight about, do I put on a back panel? Do I put on plastic? You know, what is my body material? That kind of thing. And you can see how reliable is my weapon versus my opponent. We see here with Blackadder and AJ Chorizo that his weapon is absolutely running great.
And AJ just makes such smart choices about when he goes in for these hits, when he's able to kind of get to the side and then spin into the damage. It's really, really good driving. I mean, you don't do much better horizontal driving than what he's been doing in this fight. Textbook way to drive your horizontal effectively. The kid's good. The kid's real good.
Yes, this 11-year-old builder and driver of Blackadder is very good. And AJ just has time on the sticks. I mean, like, he keeps coming to this competition, and his outing's getting better and better. Blackadder is ranked number 43 career all time, and I think that we may see an improvement in his rankings, his all-time career rankings, after this competition.
Yeah, look at him just taking apart the mini bot, taking apart the main bot.
Yep.
Slowly but surely.
Lots of
his way
small
through.
Exchanges we're seeing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's smart. It's controlled.
He's just not going to throw any crazy haymakers. He knows he's got this fight in the bag as long as he doesn't damage himself or break his weapon or become disabled. So he's just taking it easy. Showing the judges, because he's likely going to go to the judges, that he's got control, that he's doing the damage. But he's not going nuts. He's not. He's not putting himself in any real danger.
Because a lot can happen with 50 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah, this is a really smart way of doing it. You know, a lot of competitors.
Oh, he ripped off a wheel from ZZBot. Wow.
This might actually get us to a countout before it goes to the judge's decision. Because ZZBot not able to show any translational movement there at all. They're just spinning in the corner.
I saw the referee try and grab for show motion, but. No, let's see. 20 seconds left.
Show motion.
Yep, there goes show motion.
And you can see the weapon turned off on Blackadder.